U.S. Lost my soul, driving fast, lost control, off the road, y'all was broke, remember we always broke, remember I'm coming back, I'm taking all steady.
I got brought in the line, choose it to be the front, credit cards in the scams, taking all steady, legacies.
Hello, hello, everybody, and welcome to April's energy reading. Turn up, turn up, turn up. All right. For the each sign, okay? So check out your rising sign. That's the main one you want to check out, okay? Because that's how your life is basically laid out, your rising sign. That's how all the planets, based on how they fit in your houses, that's how it expresses yourself through the houses, and it starts with your rising sign. That's the first house, okay? So I'm Virgo rising, first house rising sign, Virgo. So I always check out my Virgo, the Virgo post first, because that's kind of how my life goes out. The energy of how it's going to go is your sun sign. I'm an Aquarius, so I check out my Aquarius, okay? And how I'm emotionally going to feel with it, you know, how I'm, if I'm going to react to things, if things are going to be emotionally hard for me, that's my moon sign. So then I check Gemini out, because that's my moon sign, okay? So that's kind of how you can feel with my readings. That's how it's set up and kind of how it, I feel like it goes for when you look at readings for horoscopes, okay? So I have all the signs. Check them out, and see what resonates. As well, if you want to go even deeper as well, you can look like I have Mars in Cancer, which I really resonate with. I really feel a lot of my Mars in Cancer. I also have Venus in Pisces, 29 degrees, okay? And so it's one of my, that's my most, the sign that I, the planet that I have the most wisdom in and the most experience in, so it's a pivotal in my life, and it's really, Venus transits always affect me, and so you, it's about taking, I can watch Venus videos, I mean, sorry, Venus videos, videos on Pisces, and I can understand for my Venus, okay, or videos on Cancer and understand for my Mars, so take in what you want. And that's about it. Let's get into the astrology, and then we're going to get into the cards for each sign, okay? So this month really is starting off pretty challenging, okay? We have this full moon that happened the 31st of March in Libra, okay? All about balance and really bringing in dynamics of balance in our relationships and ourselves, okay? Lots of clarity and things revealed there, and lots of things were came in to, like, revelation. I heard lots of arguments during that time, so I feel like there was lots of things getting out. Then we move into the beginning of the month, and we have so much going on with Saturn, Mercury, okay, and Mars. Mars starting out the month, Mars and Saturn were conjunct, which had us at like a halt kind of point. And then in the beginning of the week, Mercury is going to kind of get like by Saturn and by Mars, okay? They're both in Capricorn, Mars and Saturn. Trying to build us. Mars is trying to get there. And what do I want to build? You know, I want to be successful and push this forward. And let's, you know, get on this journey and build a foundation for myself. And that's how we're all feeling. We're all really trying to build and create foundation for ourselves. And that's going to continue throughout the entire month because Mars will be in Capricorn. But Saturn's in Capricorn. And he's the planet of integrity and karma. So he's making sure and slowing us to make sure we're doing the right things, okay? And we're all our motivation is in the alignment with our highest good, okay? So he's keeping us on a pause a little bit. And all that energy is being hit by Mercury retrograde, which will be retrograde the entire first half of April. So the first half of April is not the time to be starting any new major projects, doing any new, signing any contracts, starting any new, you know, major ideas or beliefs, because Mercury retrograde is a time of redoing, reprocessing, rethinking, and things change, okay? So just kind of be watching about that. Anybody new you meet or talking, you know, you meet or talking to during Mercury retrograde, be wary that after the retrograde, our mentality and things shift a lot, so it could shift you out of the relationship, you get what I'm saying? So that's happening from, it started the 22nd of March and it will go into the 15th of April, okay? And on that day, the next day, is a really amazing thing, the Aries new moon, okay? This will be conjunct, the sun will be on top of Uranus, which is the planet ruler of Aquarius, hello. And that's about sudden revelation, surprise, and electrifying insight, okay? So expect that on that new moon. It's a new moon setting new seeds, so I really think our drive for this entire new year is going to be that. Very surprising and new surprises popping up as we move forward, okay? Aries new moon on the 16th. We have our boy Saturn goes retrograde the next day, okay? Saturn really, as he's going direct, really helps us to move forward on our spiritual path in a way that aligns with our karma, in a way that really, if he restricts us and limits us, but it's to really push us forward. And we've been able since December 21st to slowly lay a really nice foundation for this empire, this new vision we want to build on. Okay, we've really been looking at any of the faults that could have occurred in building this new foundation so that we can really truly move forward in a great way. Okay, and so Saturn's going to go retrograde, which means that we've been doing a lot of paving the way forward. He's going to take a little bit of a rest so we can finally have a break of this energy of Saturn, like, oh, what are you doing? Where we can finally focus and make sure we're doing the right thing. But what occurs during Saturn retrograde is karma is now for us. It plays out instantly. So it's a karma check. Okay, so make sure you're in the right integrity this entire time, because you're not going to have Saturn on your back making you feel like you need to be integrity. He's going to be more rested, but he's watching still. Okay, and so a lot of the things you're doing are really going to come out when he goes back direct. If you're out of integrity, but also blessings come through this time, and especially when he goes direct, if you're doing the right thing in alignment, okay, and working very hard. Then we have Taurus season, okay, that starts the 20th of April, okay, so happy birthday, Taurus, starting April 20th, okay, and starting April 20th, and Taurus will pick up the 30% off sale for your season, okay? So 30% off your zodiac sign season, okay? In the 2018 year, zodiac year, okay? Not year starting in January, sorry, Aquarius, well, Capricorn, Aquarius, and Pisces. It's the zodiac year of 2018, which started at the spring equinox, okay? Then we have April 22nd, Pluto goes retrograde, okay? So Pluto has been really going through Capricorn, same as Saturn, both this energy. All this Capricorn energy will kind of slow down a touch after the new moon in Aries. We're having all this Capricorn energy to really make us think about what we're building and really put us in strong alignment with it, okay? And then we're going to slow down a little bit. Pluto going retrograde makes us think about and transform our insides. Internally, our beliefs are transforming about what we want to believe, okay? But Pluto direct has been, since, you know, this fall, really pushing forward with us and transforming us in all kind of different ways, okay? Transforming us through bringing up our fears, through bringing up our anxieties and worries, and making us having to completely reshift and reshape ourselves through that. Lots of things. As Jupiter's been going through Scorpio and exposing so many things, Pluto's been in Capricorn really tearing down lots of the old beliefs we had, okay? So much has been going on. So Pluto will go retrograde, and that'll kind of simmer down the energy. On the 24th, Venus will enter into Gemini. April is jam-packed. You see, the first half of April is kind of similar energy, tough, moving through slowly, Mercury retrograde, putting pieces together. Then the new moon happens, April 15th, Mercury goes direct. All this switching happens. Two planets go retrograde, Venus enters into Gemini. That all happens within a week and a half, okay? Taurus season begins, so much energy shifts, okay? And then we end the month with a Scorpio full moon. Which is all this energy with Jupiter and Scorp, really exposing things. We're really going to be able to get a true understanding of all things hidden, all the things we've really been trying to investigate, and we might not have all the facts. Expect them to come out on the 31st. Okay, is it the 31st? It might be the 3rd. I think it might be it's the 30th. The 30th of April. Full moon in Scorps. Okay, so that is your astrology, guys. And now we're going to get into the tarot for each sign. Enjoy. Let's go, Scorpio. I don't know why I have to come on some thug for the Scorpios. Hello, welcome to April's reading, Scorpio. All right, Scorpio moon, Scorpio sun, Scorpio rising, right? So Scorpio, April's a big month for you guys, okay? Check out the bottom of the deck. Right, the tower card. All right, number one, the first thing I got, I was like, okay, what's going on with the Scorps? And Jupiter's retrograde now. It's been going through Scorpio since October of 2017, okay? What that's been doing for Scorpios, I mean, everyone in general, it's been expanding on everything hidden in our lives. The secrets in our life, hidden motivations about ourselves we didn't even know, people's hidden alternatives, all the government corruption. But it's also really going into our desires as well, okay? And really exposing how we mesh with others, our energy, how it goes with others, okay? But as a Scorpio, it's really been expanding all of who you think you are and really making you expand and get a new complete awareness of everything about yourself, okay? And what that's doing is it's expanding and zooming in on any aspects in your life where there could be faulty foundation. Something in your life that's built up, that you've been, you know, building on, or a belief you have, that actually is not for your highest good anymore, okay? And if you continue in this route, or continue in this belief or this pattern, it's going to end in catastrophe. Catastrophe, okay? So, Spirit is really taking this month of April for you to really tap in before you have this seventh house transit of Taurus season, okay? And the full moon in Scorpio coming at the end of the month of April. Okay, so a major concluding point for you, a major understanding point emotionally. You're really taking time to wrap up and going through and laying new foundations for yourself, which is really going to take going in and really doing lots of shadow work. This, you know, Mercury retrograde as well is perfect for reflecting, reprocessing, okay? So really using this time to really go in and figure things a lot out about just how you tick and just how, you know, your lifestyle is fitting and just how, you know, everything is piecing together for you, okay? And how it's happening. If you're going into a new vibration, but you have an old vibration and pattern, it's not gonna match up. I can see things in childhood of lack mentality, and now you're trying to go to a mentality of abundance. You're gonna have to go through and relay the foundations. You're gonna have to think differently and act differently and move differently and, you know, process things differently. So this month is gonna bring a lot of that, okay? I wanna just see in general where Scorpio is coming into the month. What card just flipped over? Temperance is back out. This is crazy how much this card has been out in the majority of the readings. Temperance, okay? And so this is a time, you know, right now, Scorpio, you're really trying to find balance. And what I'm seeing is, Scorpio, you're a lot more ruled with the watery realms, okay? The intuitive, picking up, you know, intent from others, really going in and seeing what's going on, but from a more receptive state, you know, you're observing, okay? Not going out and being more left brain and how can I do this, you know? But what I'm seeing that's been happening with Scorpios, I feel like in the past, you were trying to, like, fit in or do the thing that was appropriate and do so much left brain work, so much of this logical thinking, and you were sacrificing a lot of following your intuition, sacrificing a lot of your gut, your emotional power, okay? And you lost a little bit of your power in that, or a lot of your power, okay? And so now it's about how can you refill this pond almost, because it got dried up, so that you can use the guidance and that balance in between. One foot is on in the water, one is on the earth, okay? And so really balancing and bringing it into balance. Again, look at this, this is a trinity as well here, okay? Bringing into balance, you know, your environment and yourself. This is also a time coming in where you're really practicing lots of patience, okay? Lots and lots of patience and just trying to be moderate coming in, which is a great energy. And I really think that it's a great mindset to be in as well, especially when you have that tower energy coming in that is going to be really helping with your beliefs and really reshaping your beliefs, okay? Now, let's get into what are Scorpios going to be releasing? So we have this tower. What about these beliefs? What about, you know, what spirit do we have to assist Scorpio in what they're releasing. Okay. Whoa, Scorps, what? You know, what? what? That's interesting. Okay, there's just a lot of cards. Let me just recollect the cards real quick. lot coming out for the Scorpios. Okay. So, my Scorpios, three main themes coming out for you of what we are releasing. Okay. What do I want to start with? So, I guess I'll start with... Okay. So, there is some hostility about your dreams coming true. Maybe this could be, you know, the timing. I'm not sure how this is going to work out. Doubting that things are going to work out for you. This also could just talk about delays of, you know, things that you've been wanting to manifest happening. Things taking time. What's coming in is I feel like it's all being promoted and all being occurring in your life. Because of limit, it's something limiting in your thinking. Again, I feel like it's something about a belief, okay? A limiting belief of maybe, oh my God, anytime you think about these dreams and these wishes, you know, in the gut of your stomach, there's fear that it won't happen, okay? And so what that's doing is you're putting out energy of this is what I want, but at the same time, you're putting out energy of actually, I don't want that. So you're not going to get it because it's not that constant flow of, okay, this is what I want to put out and promote, okay? I feel like this is also... you know, just anything. Again, this is funny that I feel like the block is coming in. This is a little bit of limitation because she got stuck. Remember I was talking about the water dried out in the temperance card? The water's almost dried out, okay? And it's binding you in your water sign, okay? She tried to get too practical, tried to, you know, think, okay, well, maybe this is what I should do, and this is what I should do, and getting too much in her head. And look, it's a swords energy. It's that mental energy. And that's blocking the wishes from coming true. Maybe the wishes, you know, you're thinking too much about what you really want instead of feeling it and moving off the feelings, okay? And the water is your way out. That's the opening she has through the water, through your emotions, through your guidance, through the subconscious, through the intuitive, and through what that's your true power as a water sign. That's how you're going to find your way out of this limitation, okay? So really releasing the limiting beliefs, the limiting things that have been coming in about what you want to manifest, okay? And limitations coming in about the delays that could be happening, okay? It's like, oh my God, like, why is this happening? It's never going to happen for me. No, you just might be delayed right now, okay? It's a period of rest, a period of reflection before you get the manifestation and you get all the wishes to come true, okay? Another focus, because right, I forgot to say the last card that came with that, the Fool, is after that. So I really think as we, it's limited right now. You know, your wishes are coming true, all these new things, new starts, but it's like, bam, got this block, the gate's up, basically. You can't get to the new start, okay? So really removing the block. I think that's why that tower's in here, to really shake things up so we can get to this new start, okay? Start fresh. Now, I'm also seeing that there is something in your mentality, you know, even an inability to have a refreshing start, to see things from an innocent perspective. You could have gotten kind of, you know, when you get worn down by life and don't take time to really, you know, release and re-clear and forgive and just restart, life can wear you down, you know. But what happens is it takes away your youthfulness and your excitement about life. You kind of get a little like, oh, well, a little down in the dumps a little bit, okay? So this is kind of the energy I'm seeing here. And so the advice is to bring more joy, celebration into your mentality. This is the Swords, Page of Swords, how you're thinking about things, how you're communicating, okay? What you're seeing as well. If you're only playing sad songs, play something more joyous, more happy, okay? Be around more happy energy. If the people around you bring you down, you know, think about the people around you. This is the card of celebration with people, okay? Partying. So bring your energy back up, having a sense of play, okay? And the last layer, there is imbalance in relationship, okay? But what this is all about, what is the love you're giving to yourself, okay? I think that this is an offering, you know, they're offering to each other, but at the same time, it's like there's an imbalance in the offering because this is singular. How are you bringing, what are you bringing to the table? Because we know, I've said this so many times, relationships are a mirror, okay? What you offer is what you're actually going to get back, okay? So if you're not offering up your full love or offering up, you know, balance in the situation, it's also talking about how much of this are you offering to yourself. To offer this, to offer his cup, it must be full first. You got to fill your cup first. That could be why the balance is off, okay? A lot of people are like, oh my gosh, I feel like my relationship, I'm not getting, you know, they're not taking care of me. Are you taking care of yourself, okay? They're not listening to me. Are you listening to yourself, okay? Because if you're not, they're a mirror of you. How are they going to listen to you, okay? If they're not respecting you, are you respecting your stuff, okay? So that's the energy here, okay? What are you bringing to the table within yourself and within others, excuse me? And what limiting beliefs about that can you release so that you can move forward and bring balance to not only yourself emotionally, because it's a lot of cups energy, okay? And a lot about refilling the cup, bringing back water in your life, okay? Following the emotions, following the intuition. And then that'll balance out your relationships as well, okay? Now, for Scorpio, moving into the future. So for this month, where would this month lead my Scorpio? We did have the full card coming out, as I said that, on the bottom of the deck. So I definitely think that's the energy. So we're definitely moving to complete new beginnings in the future. And it's crazy that slapped down as I said that. So now let's get to some energetic themes for my Scorpio. So Spirit, looking at the energy of the month for Scorpio, what are some themes that they're going to be focusing on? Okay. Number one, the miracle of prayer. Okay. So don't forget that we have like hella guidance and hella support, okay, in the astral realms for us. It just comes once we really sit and ask for it and intend to get support and to get guidance, okay, and really ask for help. Because a lot of it is, you know, just as much free will as we have, just as much as we have to flow and, you know, go with the flow and the will of the universe, we also have free will. And so the universe is our guides are not going to completely come in and choose for us. We have to choose. And if we don't know, they're not just going to drop hella signs. They will give us advice and guidance, but they're not going to be like, do this, do that, do that. Because we're supposed to be the ones making choice. So if you need help, ask for help, and then that gives them the will to help. They're not just going to drop all the signs until you ask, okay? Number two, we're going through a major change and transition, my Scorpios, okay? Really creating redoing the foundation is a major transition, okay? Because that really reshifts and really clears and moves into a new state, okay? And what I'm getting, this card has been coming out for so many signs. Do not hate, meditate, okay? There's lots of tension, stressful energy in the atmosphere right now with Saturn, Mars, and Mercury retrograde, all squaring each other, the sun. And it's just a lot going on, okay? And so this energy could be taken, and it could be, it's Aries season as well. It can be taken and put and used in a bad way, and it could be, you know, lead to lots of arguments and frustration. And so, but it also could be led, use this energy, it's heightened energy, that could be used to refine your mind and refine things and really work on things and process, okay, and get a lot done. So don't hate meditate. Really use this energy to be very productive, okay? Lastly, I want to get into your advice for the month. Spirit, what advice do you have for Scorpio for the month? Sorry. Okay. Number one, all about this balancing we're doing and really bringing forth not just the left brain, but the right brain. That talks a lot about this and giving and receiving. Okay? The entire universe operates in cycles similar to your inhalations and exhalations. When you only exhale, give, or only inhale, receive, you become out of rhythm with the universe. For optimum health, energy, and replenishment, balance each inhalation in your life with an exhalation. Giving and receiving. Number two, play. Okay, so I really is, you know, not stressing out too much, making sure that, you know, you are seeing joy and moving towards, you know, excitement and happiness as well, okay? So play. Beloved one, it's time to set aside work for a while. Don't worry, we will oversee your responsibilities to their completion. Playfulness, gaiety, and laughter will lift your energy so that you'll return to work with a renewed perspective and heightened energy. And lastly, notice the signs, okay? Yes, the signs you've been receiving are heaven sent. We drop feathers, coins, and other signs upon your path to remind you that you're loved and never alone. Notice the signs. All right, my Scorpios, I hope you enjoyed this reading, guys. You know, much love always to Scorps, my Scorps. If you want to get a personal reading with me, check out my website, check out my services, okay? Really cool services on there, and a lot of variety of what I offer. Check it out. I also am starting a blog on there, so check that out as well. Got an events page coming, lots of things. The website's under a good bit of work right now. I got a lot of ideas I want to add. What else did I have to say? If you are new to my channel, subscribe. If this message resonated with you and you like my message and like my channel, subscribe, share, like, comment. If you're an oldie, what's up, what's up? Thank you for continuing to watch. And that's what I have to say. That's it. Much love, guys. Enjoy the month of April, Scorpio.